Look, I don't want you to think I didn't level up. Got the deal that I want. I don't settle, bruh. I count a million a month. That's that cheddar, bruh. I got my foot on they neck. I ain't letting up. Pay attention to the opposition. But they be my friends, wanting my position. They go out there and try to stop the mission. Set a proposition just to pop the tension. Man, I'ma go. Taking my flow. They gotta go. I swear they gotta go. And they stay on my way. But I'm rocking the boat. And they stay on my page. But be talking the most. Yeah. I drill like the rain on the roof. They try to take my chain and go poof. If I'm in the game, I'ma shoot. And it ain't a thing I can do. This your girl Flaujae. Make sure y'all follow me on all social media at Flaujae and go get On My Own. It's out now on all platforms. Shout out to Hip Hop Weekly.
Hip Hop Weekly cover. Hip Hop Weekly cover. Hip Hop Weekly cover. 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 Cover.
All right, Hip Hop Weekly All Access. This is Brianna, and we're here live today with the one and only Flaujae. How's it going?
It's going great. It's going great.
Good. Good. Welcome back. Welcome back.
Happy to be back. So long.
I know, right? How long has it been? Like a year?
I think it's like a year.
Okay. Okay. Fast forwarding from then until now, what's been going on?
A lot going on. I signed my first deal.
Okay.
Yeah. To an independent label, Leveled Up Music Group.
Okay.
And now I just put out my first project on my own. It just dropped. It's hard.
Okay. Okay. Let's get into the new project. Mm-hmm. You know, you signed with the new label. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, how has the journey been just from, you know, as far as the process been like for you?
The process been confusing a little bit.
Okay.
Because, like, you know, I'm still young. So, I'm still trying to, like, find myself and, like, how I want to be in the music industry, how I want to sound, how I want to look. So, that part of the process is kind of, like, weird. But, like, the making music process is really easy for me.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Because right. I'm really, like, this project I did. I had a lot of these songs already.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I think you heard some of the last time I was here.
Yeah, that's on there. Okay.
So I had a lot of these songs on before, and like a couple of them got added. But the process of like getting signed and, you know, just putting out my first project was that was major. That was like, it's like a good feeling for sure.
Okay. All right. So with this new project you're pushing, who's on it? Like, you know, any collabs on it?
No, I didn't want any features on there.
Okay.
You know what I'm talking about? I just wanted to come out on this one and just to show people that I'm just like a solid artist. You know what I'm saying? Just show them my sound, the different sounds that I have.
Mm-hmm.
But the producers I work with Fatboy, Ayo J-Bo, Spiff, Chop House, so people like that.
What's your sound like in this new project?
Compared to my other stuff, it's more mature. It just really shows like a serious side, but like you can tell that I'm like musically sound and in tune with what I got going on.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm still rapping. You see what I'm saying? So I think I'm on a good path.
Okay. Okay. Who are some of the your influences for this current project?
This current project. The influence really was the youth, you feel me? Because
okay.
I know, like, I am the youth. So I
right.
know what we want to hear. I know what we want to listen to. You know what I'm saying? So
mm-hmm.
I knew kind of what, that's why I kind of say I got a cheat code. Because I, like, know, like, what they
right.
want to hear, what we want to hear.
Right.
And so I just knew to put a little bit of what everybody wanted. You feel me? Like, the old folks could jam out to it. The kids can jam out to it. So it was just, like, that mixture.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. I think it's well organized to where they're like, okay, I see what she's doing. Cause like the first song On My Own, it's more of like a hip hop pop song, and then you go to Level Up, and that's just a banger.
Mm-hmm.
Then you go to Tweaking, and that's like a chill mellow one.
Okay.
And then,
okay.
You know what I'm saying? You go back up to like that, like a club banger. You see what I'm saying? So,
right.
You know, it shows the different.
Okay. Pressure. Okay. What mm-hmm. else have you been up to?
I've been staying in the studio constantly. You know what I'm saying? Cause
mm-hmm.
we've been putting a lot of groundwork in, and people are really like accepting the music. So I'm just taking the criticism I'm getting from, you know, fans and all that, because, like, at the end of the day, that's who's going to listen to my music. So I'm just taking it all in and putting the process of just staying in the studio, because I know if I stay in the studio, I'm going to get a hit.
Do you get offended? Because I'm sure you get constructive criticism as
yeah.
well as, you know, great reviews and stuff like that. Do you on your social media, do you take some of that criticism, or if you do receive any, personal, or how does that, you know, affect you?
If an artist tell you that they don't care their line, I'm telling you, stuff like that, like, especially when they critique it, something you really care about, like, I really care about my music, so when they critique it, I'd be like, you don't know what you're talking about, you know what I'm saying, get a little mad, like, you don't know what you're talking about, but it really just be like, all right, watch, next time, I'm going for you, you feel me, I'm gonna give my best work, so it get on my nerve a little bit, but it really make me make my best stuff. You know what I mean?
Right. So it's like it motivates you.
Right.
Yeah, definitely, definitely. Okay, and I know that you're consistently involved in the community. Mm-hmm. What's your plans this year for, you know, Thanksgiving and stuff like that and the holidays coming up?
We're partnering with a nonprofit group. We're giving away turkeys in my city, Savannah, Georgia, mm-hmm. and pepper spray and mace and stuff like that. Because, okay. you know, a lot has been going on recently with the trafficking, the human trafficking and all that. So, it's like, everybody's still on their P's and Q's, you know, if I can contribute to that, I'm doing it in any way possible.
Right, right. Okay. All right. So, and this is in Savannah. You know, is that like the only place you typically give back and where you're from and stuff like
that? Yeah, usually. But, and after that, it's like the 23rd, I'm doing this basketball game, celebrity give back basketball game. And we're going to give away stuff there too. Okay. But I like to start in Savannah because that's where I'm from.
Exactly. Okay. All right. What else can we expect from you? You know, we're coming up to, you know, the new year, 2020. Yeah. Can we expect some shows, tours, or anything?
Yeah, for sure. 2020 got Flaujae written all over it. You know what I'm talking about? First, you know what I'm saying? Top of the year, I'm dropping. You know what I'm saying? We're about to go on a big press run in New York, so that should be dope. And then, you know, pushing my name further and further out there. And I just feel like it's like 2020 going to be the year that people really respect me as an artist and take me serious, even because I feel like it's time, especially for women in hip-hop and the youth in hip-hop.
Women are definitely leading the pack right now.
Facts. And so that's how I know it's like nobody like me in the industry right now. All the women, like, it started to become categories. You feel me? See right. how you got in the men's, you got like the Lil Uzis, uh-huh. you know what I'm saying? And then you got the Kendrick Lamar's, type like that.
Right.
I feel like in female hip-hop, it's getting categorized as like, you know, female, like, I hate to say it, but like with Jermaine Dupri said, like stripper rappers type thing. And, you know, I feel like it's nobody doing what I'm doing right now. Like, I'm not cussing. I'm not selling my body. I'm not doing none of that. But I'm not doing it to the point where it's like corny and it's like, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It's just like being who I am and people are like notarized, like noticing that. Mm-hmm. And I'm gaining notoriety from it. And like people like it because it's new and refreshing. You know what I mean? So,
what sets you apart from the females that are out now?
The fact that, okay, first of all, I'm a teenager. I'm only 16 years old, and I don't like to compete with my fellow queens. But, you know, I'm making right. really, really good music, and I'm actually writing it, and I'm actually, like, musically in tune. And it's going to be something people don't expect. And I feel like since I'm not doing the norm, and it's not even on purpose, like, people try to be weird to be different, you know what I'm saying? It's just me being me. So the fact that I'm not doing the norm is really going to set me apart. And that's why I said the lane is like wide open.
Right.
You feel me? It's wide open for somebody to drive in. Like for the males, for the youth, you got Lil Tecca. He was 17. Mm-hmm. I'm 16. You see what I'm saying? So I feel like, you know, it's coming. It's coming
right.
for sure.
Okay. All right. So what else can we expect from you, you know, going forward? You know, you talked about, you know, your tours, your shows, any merchandise or anything like that.
The All My Own merch for my new EP is dropping now. I'm not supposed to say no, but I am going on tour in 2020.
Okay.
It's gonna be, you know, on tour with a bigger artist.
Okay.
It's gonna be lit.
So we just gonna have to make sure we keep in touch and, you know, follow you.
Yeah.
So we can get scooped, definitely.
Definitely.
Okay. Well, is there anything else you want our listeners to know about that I didn't ask you about?
Just go stream that. Go stream that on my own. It's 7 tracks on it. Listen to them. Give me your feedback if you love it. Thank you. If you hate it, listen to it, stream it.
Okay.
You feel me? But on my own, out now.
Definitely.
Mm-hmm.
Well, we do appreciate you for checking in and taking the time to speak to Hip Hop Weekly.
Always.